And yes, so President Muhammadu Buhari and on still here and say negative consequence could they if the government continue to and they do subsidy for the price of petrol. And the president, where they represented by Vice President Yemi Osinbajo, and give this explanate on Monday while he been declared open and 1 2-day first year ministerial performance review retreat for the State House Conference Center, Abuja. The president here and say the COVID-19 pandemic don't lead to one obonke downturn for the money and where they available to finance the nation's budget and still severely hamper government's capacity. And this is the promise, say the government they work towards to mitigate the impact for the deregulation for the citizens. And yes, so to join us live in Akunle Wiseman Ajayi will be human rights activist. Kunle, will they hail you this Kaja Day?
How you doing now? Good afternoon. Ground.
Thank you, sir. So you join our Bonge News this Kaja Day. We want to just ask you some questions concerning this oil marketers matter. So oil marketers and Pengasan, they don't call for the remove of subsidy for December. You not think, say, the remove could affect the consumer and it could get negative impact for the economy? Or how you see them?
Normally, sir, if you look at subsidy na Ojoro, subsidy as it is soon, na robbery as it be. So if oil marketers and Pegasus and say, me they remove them, they no talk, say, me they deregulate. Okay. Don't be deregulation, they talk. If they don't come on subsidy, wait till they talk, be say, make Nigeria start to de produce your oil. Okay. Now be renationalization of the oil sector.
Okay.
Now wait till Pegasus at the talk, be that.
Okay.
Wait till Pegasus at the talk, be say, no put unnecessary money for some few people where they go to shop at. Oh. Why you not use that money to build refineries? The money where they do subsidy, they feel use them fix different all these things. It not be rocket science. So. Not be say we won't bring about test to make or do it for us. So okay. I be one wrong, go meet one petrochemical engineer, make or do new thing. For here, that just about 7 or about 10 years ago, Muhammadu Yar'Adua and I be president for this country.
Okay.
He reduced petrol price from 75 naira to 65 naira. On top of that one, he can't make sure, say, he fixed 2 out of the 3 refineries. So, today, we go to see oil, not to be like queues. And as it be so, why be say NMPC, where be say that they talk about, say, Q, why be say we don't get NMPC? To have more petrol stations where go they control by petrol workers.
Okay.
So that you know go be say some people they hoard them. Now hoarding be the issue where they happen. And because of the neoliberalism where them Buhari, them Jonathan, all our leaders don't sign with IMF and World Bank, that they allow some kind of policies where they use state they cut our people for leg. They go say, If you don't put subsidy for petrol, if you don't renationalize oil, say petrol no go there available, there will be hoarding. All those ones now bonge lie, now Tory will be saying no concern the truth.
Oh,
and wait till they do be say they will just ask all those independent marketers, say maybe they do hoarding. And if those ones don't go keep petrol put for some under bridge, we don't go see petrol. So all the regulatory commissions we get for Nigeria, PPMC, all of them, where they regulate, all of them, no day again. So why they no day be say federal government no one made them day? Now why they sign the regulation policy with IMF and World Bank? If you remember well for 2016, after we Buhari become president, for 2015, Christine Lagarde visit Nigeria. He tell us, say, make he use the popularity where he don't get with the masses to finish what Jonathan starts.
Okay.
To do deregulation, to do naira devaluation. What all of these things mean, be say, all the kind of excuses where Ogala and Mohammed could give us, so all those excuses now, excuses where they don't plan from Aso Rock. Say, Mona, commode the subsidy. If you commode the subsidy, Mona, go through full deregulation and allow Nigeria know that they suffer for the hand of the so-called independent marketers.
Okay, so as you say, you don't talk like this, you didn't make sense well, and we'll still say you do ogbonge press up on top of this matter. How you take me explain before, say, the removal of this subsidy go impact petroleum marketers? The petroleum marketers, how this removal go take impact them?
If you did talk of petroleum marketers, as it be so, our question be say, which time this same petroleum marketers, as a business, if they come on subsidy, they say they won't go do deregulation.
Okay.
Which time he no pay them? If they put subsidy, he pay petroleum marketers. They still the people will get filling stations.
Mm.
Because what they mean be say they go subscribe to that subsidy, and then go to get petrol.
Okay.
But waiting with the talk, where be the matter be say if you want common subsidy, make sure say you return the refineries. If you return the refineries, make NNPC start to the work again. Make all the petrol stations where NNPC they control, they come back. So that we go to get people. If you like, you get independent marketers. But make the state marketers, which is NNPC, make it they work well, make their boku for everywhere. As independent petrol stations they make NNPC petrol stations say, make their boku for everywhere. So, not be about independent marketers alone. It's even about the people where they buy petrol, Nigerian people themselves, where they suffer for the petrol.
Not true.
The thing we come from our own land. Imagine, say, people for Nigeria that day, we don't even get money now as a day to even buy 1 liter of petrol. Which kind of be that on top Nigerian people? So, not be about independent marketers alone with the talk. We they talk about the independent people of Nigeria as the be so. So, if they come on subsidy, may they renationalize oil. But we don't want the regulation because the regulation, they bring the deregulated hardship where we get that today. So.
Okay. And so, because of time, we could just, how you could just take advice the government right about now so that then we just clear this matter once and for all. So because this matter, as it take be, a lot of people, they complain and say in no favor at all during by this COVID-19 time. So just wrap them up with small time because of time.
Now, about testing, I talk, say, if person they do sortie, over and over and over again, and they expect different results from that state where they do you they add A plus B, and you they expect to get C. And you know, say if they add A plus B every time, now A, B goes still they give you. So now sanity now about testing, now you call her. So what will they tell federal government be say, may they reverse back? In fact, this federal government tell us now that President Buhari, where they walk up, pick up presidency, they go do petrol price for 45 naira. No part of this world where people they suffer this kind of suffer to get their own resources. Go to United Arab Emirates, go to Saudi Arabia, go to all of those places where they produce oil. None of them they pay past 65 naira. So wait till the federal government say, may they hear if there's no one here, may they listen to waiting Nigerians they talk. As it be, so people they protest for Abuja. People they protest for Lagos, people they protest for Ogun, then they protest for different places for the country, then they protest for Ondo, then they protest for Osun. Say, make all these things stop. Make federal government reverse the petrol price back to 97 naira. The war where we just stop President Jonathan for January 2012. Now, disrespect of the masses now, on top the kind, plenty people will come out. And at that time, where we come out, your guy like Mohammed, where they talk now, they part of people will come out, where abuse Jonathan, where? When some of us, they lead protests
so
everywhere.
Ajayi,
so what do we advise government say, may they go back to the old price? Nigeria people don't feel they suffer for waiting they get.
Mr. Kunle Ajayi, as you take talk, it good. It shows that you get the interest of the people at heart and make you get a bonger day after this time. Thank you so much.